There are no letters on your keyboard, right?
No.
Nothing printed on it?
No, means you have to remember them all, as it should be.
Editing objects in Blender currently it's limited to the translation, the rotation, and the scale. But you could never like sculpt over many objects, or you couldn't pose characters that had two different armature objects. Kamau has been working on the multi-object edit now in a separate branch until yesterday that it became part of Blender 2.8, the official branch. So I went and asked him how this feature came out and what's possible to do right now and how far is it. It's still a work in progress, a spoiler alert, but it's interesting to know what's there and what's not by the actual developer that made it.
So I started back in Australia doing just really basic, just drawing the different objects in edit mode. And I think over about a week, I just did a test just to see how much work it was. The actual editing is not that complicated. However, I found a lot of the work is kind of in associated areas, like the undo system is probably the most work, because you've got to have all the objects' history tracked back for every object and deduplicated and managed, and objects can be added and removed from the history. So all this stuff was actually like by far the most work. The transform system was also quite a bit of work, because we have to have the different objects in different spaces at once. And I suppose now, even though it's in 2.8, I've pushed it to the 2.8 branch, there are a lot of to-dos. Yeah. So it's, you know, even if the basics are working, you can, you know, grab some things, select them, subdivide them. There's all the operators that have not been ported over to use this. Now, porting over is often fairly simple, so I'm not worried about that. And if people like, they can help out. But, it's a big task still. And I'll probably work on that after the code quest. So, Edit Mesh Tools, and this is just basically the menus expanded. And strike through for things that are working. So as you can see, there is one thing working.
So out of all the mesh editing tools, there is one that is working that is subdivide.
Yeah, there's quite a bit to do. So yeah, it'll take some time.
This is something other like developers can help with, like people that are learning, or like Blender or developers.
If you wanted to, you could, because you can just look at what's done already, the things that work already, and you can copy and paste it and see if it works, and if there are complications, maybe move on to a different one that's easier if you're just starting out. But yeah, if people wanted to help out, that'd be great.
So this can be tested right now. This is already, you can go to the experimental videos, right, and test it.
Yeah, Blender 2.8, and you just select two objects, and the things that work well at this very moment, well-ish, are pose mode, so two armatures or more armatures, and go into pose mode. Armature edit mode works, mesh edit mode also. The other edit modes for like metaballs and lattice, they work for transform, undo, basic selection, but further, it's not very much is working.
Awesome.
So yeah, there's still lots of work to be done, but if you're a developer that's just starting with Blender, why not checking out the list and contribute with some of these thousands of operators that need to be ported over? Maybe that way we can get the multi-object edit feature complete before the code quest ends. Anyway, that's it for this very feature-specific update. Stay tuned for more. Subscribe to the Blender Developers channel for more of these kind of updates from the code quest and everything Blender development related.
To be predict- as a developer level of animation. Beautiful. All this work was worth it.
It's like some really, really terrible dance. I'm sorry.